A lot of people don't realize just how flexible Photoshop is. Let's do a whole ton of tips really fast on changing the view of things. So the first thing, toolbar on the left, we can click to make it two column or a single column. Of course, we can tear it out and have it floating. If you want to view full screen, double click the magnifying glass. This fills the view. To see the whole thing, double click the hand tool. By the way, Control 0 or Control 1 will also do that. What about the panels? Layers panel. Choose the options. Go down to panel options. And we can make these thumbnails larger. Click OK. That also works with channels. Speaking of channels, notice the red, green, and blue are all black and white. Go under preferences. Under preferences, choose interface. And we can select to show channels in color. And now you can see they display red, green, and blue. Cyan, magenta, and yellow if you're in CMYK mode. Let's go back to the interface. Put it back in black and white because it's a lot easier to work with masks. That's why it's set that way. We can change the size of the font. For the UI, you can make it smaller or larger. That will help. But we can also change the colors of Photoshop itself. Notice we can go back to the old school bright. Go through the different ones here. And of course, we can change the highlight color to blue if you want. Notice the highlight there on the left is blue. On there is blue. Default goes back to our gray. Cycle through screen mode. Hit the F key. We'll hide a lot of the interface. Hit the F key once again. We'll give us full screen. F key again toggles us all the way back. If you hit the Tab key, you can hide everything except for the working area. Tab key will bring back menu bar and panels. Just want to hide the panels, hold the Shift Tab. Shift Tab again will bring that back. Changing the unit of measurement, hit Control R for rulers. And then just right click on the rulers and now you can go between pixels, inches, centimeters, whatever you want. Speaking of, while we're here, this is how we get guides. You just drag the guides out. If you want to change the direction of the guide, hit the Alt or the Option key and you can go from horizontal to vertical. Of course, you can change it any time. Just grab it, hold the Alt Option key, and once again, drag it from the left to pull it out. To get rid of the guides, just drag them off. One more bonus one when we're working inside of a Lightroom in the Develop module. See the sliders? They're not very long. You always want to grab that, drag it out. That will elongate the sliders and give you more control over your adjustments. So how many of those did you guys know? Let me know in the comments. And also, do you have more tips to add on how to display and view things in Photoshop? Add that into the comments as well. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Great to have you with us. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my videos. I have one favor to ask you guys. Hit that like button. It helps us with the algorithm on YouTube. And until next time, guys, I'm going to see you at the cafe.